present.
I'm an overcomer. Doesn't matter what I'm going through. I know you are with me, Jesus. Whoa. With your spirit. That's what I declare tonight, oh God. Oh,
He's given us the strength together for us to meet here. These things are very profound and it's not something to be played around with. Thank you for every single one of you that has come from afar.
Merci naba mama na biso.
Thank you for all our mothers. Those who have come from afar to be here with us.
Baninga,
beloved, what I
will
tell all of us is, if you go through a tunnel, there is always an exit at the end.
Tunnel sombre ya Congo,
the dark tunnel of Congo.
Sorti na ngwana lingu tu sotia matoyo kana bien.
I really want all of us to follow what I'm going to say shortly. The work that I'm doing for things concerning Congo, as Father Jean-Guy just said, I've been doing it for 35 years. I've been speaking about things concerning Congo day and night. We prepare this event today with others. We call the music artists to come and perform today. We've even called doctors to be here with us. Historians within the Congolese community. To explain to us in short terms our history, the history of Congo. For our children that have been born here do not actually understand the history of Congo. I really want you to be a bit patient with us. I'm not looking at the numbers of people, but I'm looking at the heart of the people that love Congo. Maybe you think it's terrible. If you go to YouTube, you'll see the clips of other works that I've done with the masses of people. I've been speaking about Congo in a stadium in Kinshasa, full mass of people. Even in the people's house in Congo, I've been speaking there. If you go on YouTube and you type Reverend Danny Musumbu, you will see all the works that I've done. Maybe you're afraid and saying, how come there's such a little turnout? But for me, it doesn't matter. I've spoken about things concerning Congo in all the corners of the country. But this afternoon, I'm just here just to bring to your conscience. Just look at our friends who are the engineers that are doing the works for us today. They're from university afar. Let's just clap our hands and appreciate them.
We have seen
our Caucasian friends also here amongst us.
Some of
them have traveled from far ends of the country to be here with us.
But us all
Congolese, we must really take conscious to be aware of all these things that's happening. No one will help you if us ourselves do not take up the stand and do so. In the suffering of the US
people,
Martin Luther King stood up to influence the destiny of that nation. It is always the same in the history. I'm not speaking with hatred or anger
for
the suffering that is happening in Congo. You are eating, drinking, and being merry. But can you actually take a moment and reflect that 8 million people have died in Congo?
48 femmes sont violées chaque 1 heure du temps.
48 women have been raped every hour.
Docteur Bokelo Zawana, Docteur Mususi Yekuna, Bangumi Bale,
we have two, Frank, Dr. Frank and Dr. Bokelo, who are here.
Conséquence, il y a viol sur le plan physique.
They will also explain to us what is the consequences of rape psychologically. I thought that all the mothers of London will be here to listen and to experience what will happen today. May God bless you mothers that are here. Clap hands for those of you that are here. In the Bible, in the book of Luke 9:10, the Bible says, the doctor of the law asked Jesus a question: what shall I do in order to enter into the kingdom of God? Because this man knew the law and he wanted to test Jesus. The same manner that us children of God, today we know the law. The Bible says that the good religion is helping widows and orphans. And orphans. Isn't it true? We know the laws. Us pastors and servants of God. Us Christians and believers. Amen. The suffering of Congo, there is no one that can take it away. It is only us that we must intercede to God. But we must stand. When this doctor of the law was troubling Jesus, then Jesus responded with a parable. When you read in verse 35, now Jesus said there was a man who came from Jerusalem going to Jericho. This was signifies as the blessed
nation,
the bread country. Jericho was cursed through Joseph. Now this man was going to Jericho. Read it in your Bibles. Luke 10. When he arrived in a way, the two cities are about 1,000 kilometers apart. Now the Bible says that in a certain cul-de-sac, there were thieves waiting to trap this man. And this man fell into their snares and was beaten. And they took away all his belongings. Now the high priest of God, he went past that place. He saw how this man was beaten up. But he went past. The Levites, those were helping the high priests, he also went past the same place. Open your ears and listen to what I'm saying. Those two people went past. They did not take care of the man. But when the third man went past, the parable says that this man was a Samaritan. The Samaritan man did not get on with the Jewish people. They had no relations. But when this man was going past, the other two went past by the same way. But when the Samaritan arrived in the same place, he stood up, although he was a rejected man. He stood up at the place. The Bible says that he took that man and helped this man that was beaten by the thieves. He took him, placed him on the horse, and took him to the inn. And he gave that man 2 denarii. It means the salary of that day. He gave the money. And he said, please take care of this man. Upon my return, I will reward you. Who amongst those three people is actually the good neighbor or the good Samaritan? Who is the good neighbor or the good
Samaritan?
It's the good Samaritan who is. Congo, I can put it in the same context. We all know how Congo is laid desolate. How many times Congo has been raped? How much time or how many times are they suffering? But even the servant of God went past Congo. We compare them to the servants of God who are here in this country and those abroad. For them, they do not even want to turn up to this event. I'm saying this openly. Do not have fanatism.
Sauvons le Congo, s'il vous plaît.
We all must save the Congo. You must not have fanatism. The blood of the children of Congo
is
being spilled every day. Our women are being raped every day. 48 women are being raped every hour. Can you believe in these things? Now, the day that the World Trade Center collapsed, I saw the policemen making this movement. And every person was renouncing the person who did this such atrocities. Now, people fell on the collapsed building. Now compare the number of people who died in the World Trade Center.
8 million, s'il vous plaît.
And 8 million in Congo. Others are even being burnt alive in Congo. In the eastern part of Congo, there's about 400 women who were massacred. They digged a hole on the ground and they buried them alive. But none of the world spoke of this. No journals or newspapers spoke of these things. No pastors stood up and denounced the
atrocity.
Maybe just a few did this.
Déclaration universelle des droits de l'homme.
I read a Declaration of the Human Rights. In a certain article. I'm a pastor that does my research. I must know a lot of things.
Papa, azali avocat avant de wana yi.
There's a lawyer amongst us here sitting.
Alleluia.
Amen.
All
these women have been raped. This is one of the reasons why we're here today. So that we may remember these women and what they're going through. Because you and I will enjoy our Christmas, but what about them? I also have a wife and children. I can also eat and drink. But do you know how much time and effort it's taken to organize this work and how we suffered? Do you know how much this hall was rented? It was not the money of charity. I don't even like the charity money. There's Pastor Willie here amongst us who looks after our finances. All the things concerning Action Nehemiah comes from our own pockets. It's because we love Congo. That is why I want you to join with us so we may share the suffering. Beloved, I'm speaking about the Levites and the high priest. These people are comparable to the Congolese individuals who do not want to take care of things concerning Congo. Amen. Do we actually understand what's going on? Who is the Good Samaritan? That have taken their own money and wealth and given to help. The Good Samaritan who took the man that was beaten up. Who can help the Congo like the Good Samaritan did? Who can help the woman who had been
raped?
Like the Good Samaritan.
Other
people say, I'm not interested in Action Nehemiah because it's politics. Look, I am not a politician. I am a servant of God. Like we've seen many other people in this country. Wilterfield went and gave peace in the New England. Because there was a lot of racism at the time. This is the role of the church in a time of crisis. Jesus said, you are the salt and the light of the world. This is the role of the church. When the world is going through suffering, the church must stand up and influence destiny. Where are the servants of God of Congo? Where are the servants of God of this world? Where are the missionaries, the Church of England, the Baptists, and all other congregations? There is a time. There was a time where they showed us on TV, Central Africa, there's atrocities. And the soldiers went to give peace in Central Africa. Why not Congo?
Congo
belongs to God.
Congo
belongs to God. It's because you do not know. I always tell this to people. When God created the world, He stood up in Congo. And then He was depositing minerals all over the world. But He stood up in Congo. When He finished depositing all the minerals in His pockets, God said to Jesus, I have so much weight, I cannot walk with weight. Then Jesus said, Father, just where you stand, throw. God put His hand in His pocket. He threw. He was standing in Congo. This is what's making Congo scandal. This is the beginning of Congo suffering. It's as if God sleeps in Congo and wakes up in Congo. It's as if God is a friend of Congo. Despite the
suffering,
one day the morning will come for Congo. One day the morning will come for Congo. One day God will visit Congo. It will be the miracle of God Himself. Who will be like the Good Samaritan? Who will be like the Good Samaritan? Who is the Levite? Will look and walk past. Others say, I can't join into these things because otherwise I won't go back to Kinshasa. Oh, Congolese. God is calling our hearts. God needs all the Congolese to come together. You need to. You know, where are you today? This is the true unity. To help those who are suffering. To cry for your country. To cry for your nation. To cry for your country. Where are you, people of diaspora? You're just making noise on television. Stop making noises. Let me tell you. If someone is hungry of bread, but you give him something else, psychologically, you've done nothing to him. You must give him what he wants. The Congolese people have their own. What food are we giving? To influence the Congolese people to pray for their country. Stop making noises on television. Stop having useless debates. Amen. What must we give to the Congolese people? Someone can be at church, but they're thinking of their brothers and sisters. You can be at church, but they are telling you that their brothers and sisters are suffering. Maybe it's because you do not know the suffering of Congo. I'm calling you, and I'm telling you that God must help your heart, that your heart may become like a good Samaritan. You must not be like a Levite and pass by. Africans of diaspora. The Africans that are outside, they can even see the suffering of Congo. Who stood up in big meetings to speak about what's happening in Congo, to give peace? Who? No one. But if people will not do this to help you, it's up to you Congolese to be united. For the unity to be present, we need to have good heart. For us to have a good heart, we need sincere repentance. We must have love, want to one another. To save a nation, we need to be united. We need reconciliation. For the Congolese people. If you go on YouTube, you'll see the same message I preached in Congo, in the stadium. That is why I'm inviting all of you who has a good heart. Jesus asked, amongst the Levites and the high priest, who is a good heart? And also, together with the Good Samaritan, who has a good heart?
Question.
This is a question. Who has a good
bon
heart?
Samaritain.
It's the Good Samaritan.
Lelo na pokwa lelo?
This afternoon.
Nani okosala moninga malamu pona basura basa viole?
Who will have a good heart for these women who have been raped?
Nani okosala moninga malamu?
Who will be a good friend to them? Who will put oil to heal the wound of the person that is sick? Who will carry that person right to the inn? Who will have the heart of a good Samaritan? This man poured oil on this man that was beaten up to help him. With suffering and compassion, he even forgot where he was going. But he said, this man must be saved. He took up his money that he had. This afternoon, who will bring their kimbundis
here?
In order to identify yourself with a woman who is naked, forgive me, please. I'm a Congolese.
D'origine.
Origin.
Yeah, solo.
I'm not from Kivu. But why am I speaking about Kivu? It's because I've identified myself with their suffering. When you identify yourself with these women who have been raped, you will come to give your clothing here with a compassionate heart. You can even empty out your treasures. Us in action, Nehemiah showed you this example. But we don't get anything in return.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We
organized work in Boldwater Farm in 2011. It was a big hall.
But
the Congolese shut their ears.
Serviteurs de Dieu, pasteurs,
even the pastors, the servant of God,
closed
their ears.
Mandat 2001,
from 2001, I've never been back to Congo. My mother even died. I was not even able to go back. My brothers and sisters died. I did not even go back. It's because they changed their strategies and said that I'm a politician. I'm not a politician. Those who know us since 1978, the four messengers on Binza knows that we are not politicians. I'm begging you, please go and tell your pastors. Ask him if truly he's a servant of God. Our mother Marceline from Congo Bololo is here. She said this to them on television. I will be here to see if you, servant of God, will attend. Our servants of God love going
from
television
to the show.
This is just futilities. We just
want to slander.
We want to slander one another, but our country is burning. Please listen to these things.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What bango? They
are preaching about love.
Where
but where are the pastors? They are preaching love.
What bango?
Where are they? They are preaching love. If I tell all the pastors to stand up, you'll see there are not even more than five here. But where are the rest? If you ask them, what did the
pastor
do to you? I never slandered
them.
But I fight for Congo. It is not their problem. Congo is our country. Let us save Congo. Let us stand and save Congo. Let us save. We must stand. I'm inviting you. If you want to be part of Action Nehemiah, come and join us. We pray for Congo. We have conferences for Congo. God said this to me. Prepare my people for the return. I trust in this word that God tells
me.
I told Pastor Willie this. Please lift up your hand where you are. I told him this. 2 years later, there was a black African American
pastor
in America. He had the same vision, and God said to him that the Congolese people need to return. The engineers, doctors, all those that we know in society, you need to prepare yourself for the imminent return. It is you that must return back to build Congo with all, the knowledge that you have. You ask yourself a question, how would we return? Let me tell you. Pharaoh kept people in division. But the day that the Jewish people came together, after hearing the revelation that Moses, they all came together. When they stood before the Red Sea, the Red Sea opened its doors. The God of the supernatural. You ask yourself a question. How will Congo be delivered? It will be God Himself that will deliver. Amen. All that's happening. All that's happening in Congo. God is giving us time to come together and be united. The day that we'll come together and love one another, the war of Congo will finish. Automatically, all those that say Congo will go out of Congo. I'm calling you to come together. Doctors,
engineers,
lawyers, servants of God, all of us. Amen. I'm going to stop here. What's in my heart is a lot, but I'm going to stop here. Amen. I'm just going to read to you the law I'm just going to finish here.
Convention pour la prévention et la répression du crime de génocide.
I'm just going to speak about one of the articles.
Adopté en par l'Assemblée générale des Nations Unies le 9 décembre 1948.
It was written in 1948 by the United Nations Assembly.
Considérant que l'Assemblée générale des Nations Unies par sa résolution 96 en date du 11 décembre 1946 a déclaré que le génocide est un crime du droit des gens en contradiction avec l'esprit et le fin des Nations Unies que le monde civilisé condamne. Convaincu de ce qui suit, article 1er, les partis contractants confirment que le génocide, qu'il soit commis en temps de paix ou en temps de guerre, est un crime du droit des gens, qu'ils s'engagent à prévenir et à punir. Donc, awa,
here,
génocide est salé.
Genocide has happened.
Mais, bah, yo, kana, kina, 1948.
But in 1948, the United Nations came together.
Génocide, non, c'est pas seulement. Attends, guerre, attends, on dit, ils ont condamné. Ils ont punissable.
That every genocide that happens is condemned and is punishable.
Loi et le bon.
That's what the law says.
Mais si quoi, yoté.
But today,
ça vient après.
It's going to come.
Mokolo, bino, bo, yo, kana, bino, ba, congolais.
Not today.
Mokolo, bino, bo, komoko. Bo, pessimité, man, abino.
The day all Congolese.
Makamoyo, mokili, banglais, ba, américain, ba, français.
Now, the, what's been written in the laws, it will now be put into practice the day we all become united as Congolese. And the people that are bringing the atrocities will be condemned. May God bless you. We love you, Lord Papa Kibala. Please come forward. As they are coming forward to sing,
Papa Kabango azana simana.
We have Papa Kabango, Odi Kabango here as well.
Bande kumbele baza kuna sima.
We have Mbele music here as well.
Na bande kuna msusu ba yemba kiao.
And others in Papa Kabango.
Leru bako yemba.
As they are singing.
Yaka na kimbundi da wea kuchana.
Come with your kimbundis and you can deposit it here.
Yaka ni logo yo memipo na basi wana chana kati ya tapio.
Come and bring what you have.
Kamera kwa sopo.
Aleluya, haleluya, Yesu alodi yetu. Oh, yembe la ye. Yembe la ye. Yeah. Tu balais le noir et tout l'homme balançait le roi, balançait le roi.